Hello YouTube, welcome back to another video. Just a quick pickups video of what I've been picking up over the past couple of weeks. Nothing special, but as I said, thought I'd share with you guys what I got. So without further ado, first up, I got some more Dragon 32 games. Really loving the machine. I bought the computer over a year ago and I'm really enjoying it. I've actually got it here, so quickly show you it. There we go. Really enjoying this computer, playing games on this computer. The games are really primitive, graphically they're primitive in comparison to the likes of the Famicom and the Sega Master System, even the Commodore 64, but I'm really enjoying it. The games are fun, simple, very nostalgic. It certainly brings back so many memories. I never did own a Dragon back in the day, but my friend did have a Tandy, so the games are pretty much they're identical, so it was my goal to get back the games that I used to play at his house, and of course some new ones along the way that I didn't know about, and then I've done so. So I bought 6 in total, 1 from an eBay seller in the UK, and 5 from a site called Dragon 32 Universe, which of course specialises in the Dragon 32. So I'll show you those games first, and first up is a game called Space Raiders, which is actually a clone of Space Invaders. Now, all these the 5 games that I got from Dragon 32 Universe, they were £2 each, so £10 plus £6 postage, £16 in total. So yeah, back to Space Raiders, which is obviously a clone to Space Invaders. There is a screenshot inside, very small, but I'll do my best to show you guys. If you can see that, once the camera focuses, there we go. A very cool Space Invaders clone. Really chuffed for that. Next up is a game called Talking Android Attack, which is basically a clone of Berserk. And talking because it does have speech. Fortunately, there's no screenshots, just the description and of the game itself, and of course instructions. Of course, we have tape. So yeah, let's put that away like so. Next up is a game called Intergalactic Force. Anyone familiar with Atari's Star Wars, where you're going through the trench and Death Star? Death Star scene. It's pretty much like that, really. Very basic, but you get the idea. It's very similar. Again, there's a screenshot. You can see that. You can see a couple of TIE fighters there going down the trench. So yeah, another fun little game. Of course, you got the tape. Next game is a game called Shock Troopers, which is a platformer shoot-em-up sort of game. And as you can see there, it's also compatible with the Tandy TRS-80. On the computer, I believe, yeah. But, otherwise known as the Coco 2. Fortunately, there's no screenshots. There you got the tape there. And description of the game, and of course, instructions on the inlay. They're all in great condition. And the final game from Dragon 32 Universe is Time Bandit. And this is a sort of maze shoot-em-up sort of game. Can't know whether to describe it as a gauntlet sort of game. Not really, but it sort of plays sort of like looking down. But yeah. Fortunately, there's no screenshots, so I can't show you, but description, of course, instructions. And I do believe not too long ago there was a homebrew version of this game for the Atari ST. So yeah, Time Bandit, as you can see, most of these games were all by Microdeal. Big supporter for the Dragon 32 back in the day. So yeah, and the final game was from, as I mentioned earlier on, was from an eBay seller in the UK, and it's a game that I've been wanting to get for quite some time, and mail order shop in the UK that I've mentioned in the past called retrogames.co.uk are selling it. They do have it, but they're asking £40 for the game. And it's a game called Cop to Snatch. I mean, £40. Now, including postage, I paid £5. So I'm really chuffed to have this game. And it's basically, anyone familiar with Super Cobra? Konami Super Cobra? I used to play Super Cobra on the MSX back in the day. It's basically that. And Super Cobra is basically Konami's clone to Scramble. This game is very hard. I can't get far into it. It's just very hard. So, but still a fun game. So those are my Dragon 32 games. Actually, I've built up a nice collection of Dragon games over the past year. I do have some more on the way. So in total, with those ones, once they get here, I'll have about 60 games now on the Dragon. So I've built up a nice little collection for the computer. I'm not planning to get loads and tons of games, but just put up a nice little collection of 80 to 100 games, because I'm quite happy with just loading the WAV file onto the MP3 player and run it from there when I do get the games to work, because not all of them do load up successfully. So, but yeah, I'm really pleased with the machine. Very fun. Games are really fun, really enjoying it. So yeah. So this was my games that I got for the Dragon. Now next up is games that I got for the MSX. Only three cassette games. So first up is a game called Jack the Nipper 2, Coconut Capers by Gremlin Graphics, one of my favourite British software developers or publishers back in the day, because they're a big supporter on the MSX. And they're actually going to be there at Replay this year, so I'm really looking forward to stopping by and listening to their conference, talking about the good old days. And I've got some screenshots on the back. I'll show you those. There we go. Jack number two. Now I actually got this game, talking about them earlier on, from Retro Games. And this was £9, including £3 postage. A little pricey, but I've only seen it come up a couple times on eBay for about £2 or £3, but I'm always getting outbid, so I figured, oh, what the hell, why not? Get it now, I'll never will. So, pretty pleased to get it. Pretty chance to have that in the collection. Next up is from the final two games I got for the MSX was from an eBay seller in the Netherlands. First game is a game called Star Buggy, which is basically a clone of Moon Patrol. You can see a screenshot there at the back. A really fun Moon Patrol clone. Been off this game for quite some time. I've only seen it come up once. So I paid €6 or €7 for this, but I'm really pleased to finally own that in to add it to the collection. And the final game is a game called Zoot by Bugbyte, budget development label. Now this game sort of reminds me of that BBC game called Frack. I've actually got that game on the Commodore. It's obviously not the same game, but it looks like it plays along the same lines. I've yet to play it, and it does have speech from what it says here. Yeah, it does have speech. Yet to play it, because I've been playing quite a bit of this actually, Star Buggy, really fun game. So yeah, it really does look a bit like Frack. Obviously a budget down version of the game itself. Big characters. So yeah, really pleased to get that. So I'll have to be loading that up sometime to give it a go. See if it is or not. So those were the games that I got on eBay. Now, I did, not game related, I did get peripheral for one of my older computers, the BBC. I also got a BBC just over a year ago, and I've yet to have any joysticks for it because the ports are not the same as the Atari standard ports at the back of the BBC. And I've yet to come across any BBC micro joysticks, and I've come across a couple, but they weren't in the best of shape, and they were described as for parts or not working. So I tried looking for something that's similar to what I got for the Dragon 32, which is this, which obviously you hook it up to the ports on the Dragon, and on the other side you got the Atari standard ports, so you can plug in any type of joystick, which I use this one here, the Pro Stick, I think it's called. Really good joystick, so I use that. And I actually did find one for the BBC, and here it is. The ProTec BBC joystick interface. And it's boxed with instructions. Instructions there, and there we have it. And it's just got the one Atari joystick port on the back. Not a problem, because I don't have friends that come around here to play on my old retro machines. They're more into the current stuff, so it's pretty cool. And this was, hold on a sec, this was £12 plus £4 postage. So again, £16. Really glad to finally own something on the similar lines as this for the Dragon. Because that way I can just use the Atari joystick. Or, as I mentioned, the what it's called now, but you know what I mean. There we go. So really chuffed to get that. Also onto items that I picked up here locally. Got a colleague of mine at work, who popped into a local second hand shop and spotted an old retro computer, automatically forwarded me because he knows I'm into all this retro stuff. And he told me what a computer was, and I didn't believe him at first because, I mean, to see one of these computers here in Madeira, it's like a lottery room, really. So I popped in the next day, and sure enough, he was telling the truth. And that computer is a ZX Spectrum. I mean, to find one of these here in Madeira, I mean, it's, like I said, it's a lottery room, really. And it came with the tape recorder. There was a tape inside, which has, I guess, all sort of copied games. I mean, I played a couple of them. But again, I'm not planning to buy games for this, because I've just used the MP3 player, load up some WAV files in, and just play from there. We're good to go, really. It's not in the best of shape. There is, I mean, paint's worn off there. Bit there, really, and it's also missing three of it, of the rubber feet, but I have since got new ones from a shop called it's over here, from a shop called, there you go, and if you can see that, RWAP Software in Staffordshire, UK, and there's their website there if anybody wants to head on over and check them out. So yeah, it's just a couple pounds. And I've also, from those guys, I'm also ordered a new faceplate. So hopefully we'll get this ZX Spectrum looking brand new. And it does work. All I need now is, it did also come with the power supply and all the leads, but Unfortunately, I don't have a joystick interface, so if anyone in the UK has a spare joystick interface that's willing to trade or sell, please let me know. I'm really pleased with that. So, yeah, and the price for this, he was asking €49 for this, obviously including the tape recorder, which was pricey. I tried to haggle it down, but he won't have any. Haggling in Madeira, it's not going to happen. They will just not budge on the asking price. So I figured, oh, whatnot, what the hell. I couldn't leave it there. I had to take it home. So now I've got a ZX Spectrum. Really chuffed for that. I'm really pleased. So put that there. And the last couple of items was from a local boot sale. It's 3 PS1 titles and 2 PlayStation 2 games. Oh, I'm also, current gen wise, my daughter picked up Naruto game, which is the Ultimate Ninja Storm Generation. She's really into these Naruto type games. Not my cup of tea really, but she's playing it. She got it for €20. And as you can see, it's the Essentials Collection. She's not fussed. As long as she gets to play the game, she's a happy bunny. And for me, I picked up a PS Vita game. PS Vita's not been getting a lot of love lately because I've been playing a lot of the 3DS. So I figured I'd get a game. And this was going for €20. Games over here in Madeira tend to go for about 30. And since this was going for 20, I figured, why not? I mean, I do already have this on the PlayStation 3. But my daughter plays that more. I also have the first one, which is also good. So I figured, why not give it a go on the handheld? And that is Sonic All-Star Racing Transformed. And it's actually a good game. Really enjoying it. Gotten quite far into it. So it's another nice addition to my PS Vita collection. At the moment, I'm playing it. But as you can see, there's Tearaway there. So yeah. That brings up my PS Vita collection to 3. So, not bad. Those are the current games that I got. And back to the games that I got from the boot sale for the PlayStation 2. I do own this game already on the Dreamcast. He was asking €5. I tried to haggle him. Managed to get a euro off him, so I got it for 4, and that is Alone in the Dark, The New Nightmare. It is boxed and complete, in great condition too. I do have this already on the Dreamcast, but, you know, nice addition to the PS2. Why not? And the second PS2 game that I got was Mortal Kombat Shaolin Monks. Again, it is boxed and complete. So yeah, again, I managed to knock off a euro, so in total 8 for those two. And the final lot was 3 PS1 games. And this is from the same seller, was about a week later. I think it was about a week later, he was still there. And so yeah, 2-3 PlayStation, there was a few more there, but they were more sport titles and I wasn't really interested. There was a couple of others there that I really did have, so these three caught my interest. So first up is a game called Chaos Break, which is sort of Taito's version to Resident Evil, but this is more sci-fi themed than horror. If you can see that. Now all these were €4 each. They're all complete. This is complete. Sorry, I should say, but the only problem with it is, I don't know who, someone's ripped off one of the sides, which is a real bummer, but anyhow, what can you do? But other than that, the other side's still intact, so you can still go on the shelf like so. You wouldn't notice the other side not having the name on the other side. Again, same thing again with this one, but this one's in slightly much better condition, but again, it's missing the one of the sides, and that is vacant storing. But it's in lovely condition. Manual's nice and clean. This doesn't look like it's been used. But for €4, and as I said, it is missing the one of the sides, but then again, it's not the side that's you're gonna sort of put it up on the shelf like so. So you still see the game's cool. So not bad. Not a problem. And the final game is just a. He had it like this actually, because he didn't have a standard PS1 case. I do have this game already, so it's up for trade. It's just a disc and the front cover only. There is a Portuguese manual, but it seems to be more photocopied than anything else. Although this is how they actually do get the Portuguese manuals, in comparison to the glossy booklet that we get on the other PAL on PAL games. And that is, oh god, it's falling out. It's in a DVD case, and that is Parasite Eve 2. I do have this game, but I couldn't leave it there. So if anyone's interested in just having a little bash at it, let me know, and I'll send it over. It just comes with the obviously the front cover, and as I said, the manual is in Portuguese. So it's all like, and this is how manuals would come. You'd get the glossy book, but then you get this an additional smaller manual that's been obviously translated into Portuguese. Of course, you've got two discs. There you go. As I said, if anyone just wants to have a little bash at it, not too fussed about the not having it complete, I'm quite happy to send it over. So let me know. Sorry about that. The batteries to the camera finished, and I'm starting to have issues with this camera. I don't know if it's because it's the camera itself, or maybe battery is getting old, but it's starting to. I really need to look into that, because it's starting to bug me. But anyway, I thought I'd show you a couple of items that I forgot to show you guys, and it's not gaming related. I thought I'd share with you guys anyway, and maybe if you're interested in knowing. I've also got another collection on the side, as well as the gaming and of course the action figures and the comics. I do like collecting the odd vinyl, and I got three from an eBay seller in Germany. And funnily enough, the group's called Berlin, and you probably know them more for the track that they did for the movie Top Gun, Take My Breath Away, which was in 86. But I've known them since 82. They are an LA, Californian band, started in 1978. Now, the reason for calling themselves Berlin has nothing to do with any German connections, but more to do with the fact that they were inspired by German groups, the likes of Kraftwerk, Devo, and Sparks, so hence the name Berlin. And they released four albums in total until 1986. Now, I've yet to get the first one, which I've seen come up a couple times on eBay, and most recently I've seen one going for £95, which really is over the budget for what I'm willing to pay for a vinyl record. But hey-ho, just keep on holding out for a cheaper one to come along. So I've just got the second, the third, and the fourth album. So I thought I'd show you guys the albums. And the first one is, which is the second album, Pleasure Victim. As you can see, very 80s there. They were a new wave band. I'm pretty much into new wave back then, and I still am. The likes of OMD. Of course, Blondie, although she does occasionally go for a bit of punk rock, and Kraftwerk, and so on. So yeah, there's the back. Check out the hairstyle. Of course, the sleeve on the inside. Very 80s. The lead singer, that's the lead singer called Terry Nunn. She's now the band split up in 1986 but reformed in 2000 or 99 or 2000, and she's the only original member left in the band, all the rest of them new. So yeah, so there you go, some more photo shoots there. Of course, words and lyrics of the actual tracks themselves for you to sing along. So yeah. Now the second record that I got, which is the third album, is the one I tend to listen to the most, and that's an album, and that's called Love Life. Do like the cover to this, got that 40s star to it, but of course on the back, it's very 80s. Sorry about the glare there. Of course on the inside, you've got sleeves, record sleeves of course. Then you've got some photos there of the group, the band. Again, notes to the songs. The record comes in another white sleeve, and someone's actually wrote the sporting on the 13th of the 4th, 1984. Berlin, Love Life. 1984. Damn. Well, you younger generation haven't seen a vinyl. There we go, it's like a very large CD. And they're in actually beautiful condition for their age. And the final album that I got, which was their final album, album number 4, which is the one that includes the Take My Breath Away, is Count Free and Pray. That's the cover there. Now the reason for their splitting up was because of the that song itself. I mean, the song that made him successful was the song that broke them apart, because it wasn't their usual sort of not their sort of music. It wasn't the sort of the stuff that they played. Now this track was given to them by Giorgio Moroder. Anyone who's familiar with him, he did loads of soundtracks back in the day, in the 80s especially. And the one that comes to mind is Electric Dreams, which he did with Philip, was it Oakley from the Human League. Yeah, so sadly that song itself broke the split up the group. So I'll show you some more photos of the band. So there you go. There's a non-gaming item that I got. I do have some more vinyls on the way. Actually, I've got some Blondie albums. Got 3 on the way. I do have these on, I could have got them on CD, but I do have them on MP3, and so I'm quite happy with that. And it was just nice to get them on vinyl and play them on the old record player, so I'm really pleased with that. And in total it's €32, including postage, €7, just over between €6-7 per record. So yeah, really pleased with that. So it's my little collection on the side, which you guys might want to know. Also, finally, thought I'd mention it to you guys on YouTube, if anyone's interested. I'm trying to get an MSX game called Frogger. Now it's loose, and at the moment it's going for £60. A box copy goes for about £300. So I was thinking of letting go of one of my spares reproduction copy of Blue Sapphire. It does have another title, with Blue Sapphire at the end, but I've always just called it Blue Sapphire. Now this is a reproduction of the obviously the original. The original goes for about £400 to £500, and I do see some reproduction copies going for about £150 to £200. Now I've actually got this up on eBay going for £120. Now just purely so I can raise those funds, get those funds to get that Frogger for the MSX. But if anyone in the YouTube community with a PC Engine CD is interested, I'm not asking for silly money. It's purely so I can raise the money to get to that game. I'm looking between £60 to £70, including the postage, £70 at the most, just so I can get that game. Now, it is complete and beautiful condition. I'm saying that I have dropped the spine card, but no, it's fine, it's fine. Trust me, it's fine. So there you go, it has a spine card. Beautiful reproduction. It'd be hard to tell it was the original, a copy. Of course, you've got a registration card. And, of course, the CD itself. Now, the reproduction CDs, you can tell that they're copies because the writing on the CD itself, down here, on where the barcodes are, I don't know if you can see there, it should say care for data. That's how you can tell it's a reproduction copy. But it's beautifully done. You can quite get away with thinking that this was the original. And that's the way, you know, sometimes you've got to be careful, even with the originals, because they don't tell you, they say it's the original. You end up paying £400 or £500, and it turns out to be a copy, reproduction copy. So all I'm asking for is £60, £70 at the most, including postage. I'll show you the manual actually. It's beautifully done. Now I do have my own copy. Again, it's a reproduction copy, but it's a fantastic game. One of the best shoot 'em ups on the PC Engine. So I'm asking anyone in the YouTube community, gaming community first, if there's anyone interested in the game, let me know. If not, well, I'll just put it back on eBay and see what happens. I'm very likely to sell it, but I'm trying my luck and see how it goes for 120. And that way I can try and purchase another MSX game that I'm trying to get. Trying to get also a Magical Tree. That tends to go for about £60-70 also. So there you go. It's Blue Sapphire. So that's about it really. That was my pickups for the week. I am still expecting some more Dragon games and also some Famicom games that have yet to arrive. It's taken forever to get here. I mean, I have got in contact with the seller. He has assured me that they are on their way, so I'll see what happens there. And other than that, I don't think I'll be getting any more. I won't be doing any more pickups now, because I'm actually saving up now for obviously for replays. So I'm really looking forward to going and also meeting up with you guys for chit chats here and there. So yeah, I guess that's it really. There's nothing else to. Have I missed something else? No. Yeah, that's about it. Right. So bye for now and take care. Okay, then I'll probably get a copyright warning notice from YouTube. You know what? To hell with it. I'm going to play you a track from Berlin's Pleasure Victim album. And I'm going to play it on my Kenwood. Now, as of March 2014, the system will be 20 years old. Of course, bought it in March 1994. Cost me $1,500 at the time. I tell you what. I didn't go out for a very long time in order to pay for this beast, but you know what, it was worth it. I would never part with this system. Love it to bits. Even if it broke down, I'd still keep it. Never throw it away. I just love it to bits, and it's still going strong. And it also came as well as the speakers. Obviously, it came with these special Omi speakers. Sorry about the lighting there, but there you go. There's the other one over there. Creates an environmental sound, basically a DSP, a digital sound processor. So yeah, just quickly play you a track. And the first track is called The Masquerade. And this was 1984. There we go. Subwoofer down there. change the equalizer. It's that Knight Rider there, is what I tend to call it. Call that one Vector Graphics. And this one does a sort of demo. But I tend to go for this one. So there you go. I'll quickly stop it there before I get some copyright warning issue there. Funnily enough, this will probably be banned in Germany. Anyway, bye for now.